Father's auspicious apples lets you see 3 seconds into the future.
W dzisiejszym odcinku nowego głównego bohatera pokażę wam, jak w miarę wcześniej w grze, no to powiedzmy 6-7 poziom, okraść laboratorium Arkemera. Stonehill is going to
kill me. Don't drag me into your mess, Bertenno, not again.
Then you leave me no choice. I'm sorry.
Hey, come back with that, Madiko! Look what that flaccid pazzo! Imp, you heard none of that, huh? That's what I thought. What am I going to do? Think, Fasina. My postenago of a lover stole Rokawa's fingers. The master will kill me if I don't get them back. He must have wanted to raise some fast coin. Arkemir will flay me alive over those damned gloves. Is it strange? I don't know. Go consult Arkemir's grimoire if you're that curious. He said that he's in debt to a Raotian captain by the name of Hamuto Stonehill. By all accounts, a deadly serious man. Not that it's any of your business, but Bertenno used to spend a lot of late nights here. I got into the construct's guts and marked off Bertenno as a safe visitor so they would not attack him. And before you ask, no, I will never do this again. You do not know Arkemir, do you? He is as cheap as a Wodican clerk. Whatever he loses from those gloves, he will take out on me, somehow. You will? If you are expecting some payment or reward, I do need to keep this under wraps. You look capable. While I am stuck behind this counter, I am in no position to refuse help. A discount goes without saying. You're saving me a world of trouble by doing this. I do not know where Bertenno fences his goods, but he mentioned an appointment at the Brass Citadel docks. Hamuto Stonehill must be as dangerous as he sounds, or else Bertenno wouldn't be so panicked. Bertenno stole Rokawa's. Suddenly my whole existence revolves around. I am the apprentice of He of Many Colors. That's plain old Arkemir to you. What few spells I know have names like Arkemir's Dripping Scourge or Arkemir's Malevolent Codpiece. He made me conjure a household staff of imps. Horrible, chittering things. I think it's because he knows I hate them. Ah, he makes me call him by the titles he's earned in his long career. I can also call him by the titles I've made up since the start of my apprenticeship. To me, he's the bringer of foul wind, the teeth of suckling imps, and the herald of dirty slippers.
Jakby to niejasno wynikało, tutaj trzeba wejść po tych schodach na górę.
Your service.
Ah! Well, if you insist. Blast. Jam it.
Didn't work.
Somehow it always ends in bloodshed.
Lavaru beyond seek.
Speak freely.
This is...
Still got...
What do you need? Well, don't see why not.
Be discreet.
You want to see this?
Hmm? Well, that's not nice. Guess that wasn't so hard.
Sure.
You read my mind. This is a work of art. At once.
Well, that's not nice. All done. Yeah? Of course.
What you do here, biped groundwalk filth? What you do here, huh? Why you trouble Yellow Eye 3? His master? Give passphrase or get chewed to mush! Master or not, it's good enough for Yellow Eye 3. Yellow Eye 3 happy to serve Master. His best imp, huh? First Yellow Eye died, second Yellow Eye died, now his third. Master gave Yellow Eye a number, so he would remember which one he was. 4, 5, 6 is all the same to this Yellow Eye. One died asking idiot questions. 2 died stealing baubles. 3 is more careful. 3 watches out for kabooms. Pretty crystal. Protect you forever. Go on. Yellow Eye 3 has time for Smelly Groundwalker. Found lying near vault. Kept safe for master. What you want? Is on the lowest level, southeast corner. Sealed up like dirty secret. Burglars tried to open, but they turned into food.
You wanted something, Captain? You could say that. I'll go ahead and say it. You're halfway toward all right. Harmless compliment, I promise. Have you ever... Dumb question, but here I go anyway. You ever gotten close to someone... Even though it just wasn't... ordinary? Yeah, that about kicks the legs out from under ordinary, doesn't it? What I'm talking about is a scenario where a difference in rank can get in the way of... enjoying shore leave. Yeah, that about covers it. I'm just testing the direction of the wind here. Best not to overthink it. Interesting answer. I like the sound of that authority. I've enjoyed that sort of arrangement before. Nothing to suggest I won't enjoy it again someday. Naturally. It's all hype. Well, I've laid out my thoughts. You must have a couple. Be a pleasure, Captain. Funny thing is that Ishii can get particular about people. And when he doesn't take to someone, neither do I. Did I say that? Not everyone's a bird lover. That's fine. Some days I can't stand another second of Captain Stinkfeathers. But Ishii and I are never parted for longer than a few breaths. Take that however you will. Try not to use any foul language.
Well, this is unexpected. What exactly did you set out to accomplish by peering into the soul of this noble creature? You must put a great deal of faith in Maya to find yourself in this situation. Are you so certain that she deserves your trust? The prospect of sharing her company I can tell from here that it intrigues. Far be it from me to judge affection. Better that it bloom or wilt uninterrupted. While the dead fire is being cut, cauterized, and trampled, it is charming to find someone who makes time for such elaborate foreplay. Do you often turn to birds for relationship advice? I sense that Maya does not easily allow others into her confidence. She is observing you closer than you might guess. She has much on her mind. This may all be a whimsical diversion. That, or she is softening you up for the red work of her masters. Or, didn't you know? Perhaps it isn't for me to say. All in good time. Ah, I babble. What does the goddess of creativity know of Kith courtship? I can say for certain that this is a very hungry, overworked, and at times underappreciated bird. He and Maya share that much in common, at least. Beyond that, I leave the rest up to you. Observing, the one you call Ishiza makes for a convenient lens into your travels. Try not to take it too personally. Best of luck in your mating ritual, Watcher.
I hope that was as amusing for you as it was for me.
Hoo-wee! About time we took a breather. My feet are blistered something fierce. Tell me what's on your mind. They're there in my head when I sleep. And sometimes, I can taste them on the back of my tongue like a smear of grit. Happens when I take in a particularly volatile soul. Sure thing, Watcher.
You ask so little. A clever gambit. Feeling I've done this before. at once.
Why master need books? Not even taste good. Where'd shiny crystal go? Butler on second floor lounge trying to eat it again. Master will be displeased.
My mind.
keeping with...
All done.
Read my mind. I've done this before. You'll want to see this.
Well, all done.
I've done this before.
Working very
don't touch anything.
At your service. Naturally, how curious.
Well, that's not nice. Well done. Well, that's not nice. Guess that wasn't so hard. Well, as long as I don't get... Guess that wasn't so hard. Yeah? I got it.
Heard about that stunt you pulled in Queen's Birth, scaring everyone half to death. Tell me, do the spirits watch everything you do? Like, everything?
To na tyle, jeżeli chodzi o laboratorium w tym zadaniu i w tym odcinku. Zobaczymy się w następnym. Tymczasem dzięki bardzo za uwagę i do usłyszenia.